Good morning, Beaufort High. My name is Genesis.
My name is Tania. Today is Wednesday, February 26th.
And this is your Beaufort High Morning News. Briggs versus Elliott. The Briggs case was named for Harry Briggs, one of 20 parents who brought the suit against R.W. Elliott, the president of the school board for Clarendon County, South Carolina. Initially, the parents had asked the county to provide school buses for the black students as they did for white. When their petitions were ignored, they filed a suit challenging segregation itself. Reverend Delane, a school principal, was instrumental in recruiting the parent plaintiffs and eliciting the help of the NAACP. Thurgood Marshall, lead counsel for the NAACP, and Harold Bulwer, a local lawyer, filed Briggs versus Elliott in the fall of 1950. A three-judge panel at the U.S. District was presented with substantial psychological evidence and expert testimony presented on African-American school conditions. The court denied the plaintiffs' request to abolish school segregation. Instead, they ordered the school board to begin equalization of the schools. In a lone dissenting opinion, Judge Jules Waring admittedly opposed segregation in public education. Facing retaliation from irate segregationists, Waring left the state soon after. Delane and Harry Briggs also lost their jobs as a result of the involvement with the case. Briggs versus Elliott was the first of five cases combined into Brown versus Board Education. At the time, Brown reached the U.S. Supreme Court. South Carolina was one of the 17 states that required school segregation. South Carolina law required complete segregation. Article 11, Section 7 of the 1895 Constitution of South Carolina read as follows. Separate schools shall be provided for children of the white and colored races, and no child of either race shall ever be permitted to attend a school provided for children of other race. The U.S. Supreme Court declared racial segregation in public schools to be unconstitutional, violating the 14th Amendment's Equal Protection Clause. Following the Brown's decision, the district court issued and decreed striking down the school segregation law in South Carolina as unconstitutional and requiring the state schools to integrate. This has been a moment in black history.
Seniors, please submit your nominations for senior superlatives in the BHS Class of 2020 Google Classroom by Thursday, February 27th. Voting will take place next week beginning March 2nd, 2020.
Students, please remember that you are required to wear your ID around your neck and visible during the school day. If you don't have your ID, you are required to get a temporary ID. You must get your temporary ID in the morning before first period. Your temporary ID must be placed on your shirt near your heart. You can receive a temporary ID before school in the lobby area or from an administrator in the pods. Any student who doesn't have an ID by the start of second period will be placed in ISS for the remainder of the day.
Rising sophomores who have applied for AP Capstone for next year and who have not yet scheduled an interview with Ms. Colbert must do so by Friday, February 28th to be considered for the program.
BHS Student Leadership Conference is this Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Local political and business leaders will be here to talk to students about leadership and civic involvement. All Beaufort County middle and high schools are invited. All students are encouraged to attend. Lunch will be provided and students will be able to talk and meet personally with these local leaders. Raffle prizes and refreshments will also be provided.
The Class of 2023 is hosting a spirit night at Moe's on March 3rd from 5 to 9 p.m. A portion of the proceeds will be donated to the school. Hope to see you there.
Attention students, it's time to vote for the South Carolina Young Adult Book Award for the 1920 school year. If you've read at least three of the nominated titles, go to tinyurl.com/bookawardballot and select your favorite title for the year. See Ms. McKay or Ms. Marshall in the media center with any questions. Please make sure to cast your vote this week. Voting will close at 8 a.m. on Friday.
Hey, Beaufort High, I'm Tonight, and this is your sports news. Today, JV and Varsity Boys Lacrosse will host May River for matches at 5:30 and 7. Girls Lacrosse will travel to May River for a game at 6. JV Baseball will host Bluffton for a scrimmage match at 6. That's your sports news. Go Eagles.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated for a moment of silence.
And that's your news.
See you. around school.